Principal of the college to act as the chairman of this national webinar on the occasion of National Mathematics Day. Sir, I am welcoming you to the virtual day. Now, I feel extremely proud to invite our honorable chief guest, Professor Neena Gupta, recipient of Ramanujan Award, the pride of India, onto the virtual day. Now, I would like to welcome honorable joint director of APCC Vijayawada, Dr. R. David Kumar Swami, onto the virtual dais. Now, let me invite today's guest of honor, Dr. I. Vijay Babu, Principal, Dr. V.S. Krishna College, Shakapatnam, onto the virtual dais. I would request each and everybody connecting through this national webinar for making it grand success. Thank you all. Charvani and you?
అంటే ఇది సపరేట్ కోటింగ్ కనిపించి ఇది ఒకటి
శ్రీనివాస రామానుజన్ అయ్యంగర్ विंशतितमशताब्दे ग्रन्थशास्त्रज्ञेषु प्रपञ्चे लब्धप्रतिष्ठेषु भारतस्य श्रीनिवासरामानुजन् ग्रन्थशास्त्रज्ञेषु प्रपञ्चे श्रीनिवासरामानुजन् महाभागः अन्यतमः अयं बाल्यादारभ्य ग्रन्थशास्त्रे असमानप्रतिभां प्रदर्शयति स्म त्रयोदशतमे वर्षे एव नैकान् सिद्धान् अवगत्य नूतनसिद्धान्तान् अनेकान् प्रतिपादयति अयं महाशयः श्रीनिवासरामानुजन् तमिळ्नाडुराज्ये ईरोड् नाम पट्टने सप्ताष्टाधिक अष्टादशशतम् 1887 वर्षे द्वाविंशत् डिसेम्बर् तमे वर्षे द्वाविंशत् डिसेम्बर् तमे दिनाङ्के मातामह्याः गृहे जन्म आवाप एतस्य मातापितरौ के श्रीनिवास अय्यङ्गर् कोमलतम्माल् महाभागो आस्ताम् तमिळ्नाडु सर्वकारः रामानुजन् वर्यस्य विजयान् स्मर्तुं तस्य जन्मदिने डिसेम्बर् द्वाविंशत् राज्यसाङ्केतिकदिनोत्सवं कुर्यात् इति प्रकटीकारः भारतसर्वकारः विंशत्युत्तरनवदशशतं तमे वर्षे पञ्चसप्ततितमजन्मदिनवासरे सङ्ख्याशास्त्रे तेन रामानुजन् वर्येण कृतविशिष्टपरिश्रमं प्रशंसन् पत्रालयपथकमेकं तस्य नाम्ना लोकार्पणमकरोत् द्वादशाधिकद्विसहस्रतमे वर्षे पूर्वप्रधानमन्त्रिणा श्रीमन्मोहनसिंह महोदयेन रामानुजन् महाभागस्य जयन्तीं पुरस्कृत्य राष्ट्रीयगणितदिनोत्सवत्वेन प्रकटायमास जयति भारतं जयति संस्कृतं धन्यवादः
A small speech on founder of this college, His Highness Maharaja Vijayarama Gajapati Raj. R. Ishwar Rao, first B.
Vidyaya Vindate Amrutam. By education, we can get moral. A very good afternoon to one and all. My name is Arishwara Repalli. I am from BA first year Maharaja Government Sanskrit College, Vijayanagaram town. Today I am going to tell about our founder of MR Government Sanskrit College, Vijayanagaram town, dynasty of Pusapatis, His Highness 4th Vijayarama Gajapati Raju. In his ruling, education has been elevated drastically. He has been established Sainik School where Korkonda Palace in 1911. He inaugurated MR Music College in 1919. He built permanent building of Maharaja Government Sanskrit College in 1860, but the students faced a lot of struggles in the Banaras University for learning Sanskrit and Vedas. This is the main reason for the birth of Sanskrit College. So many poets and scholars are wrote good kavyas and critic books in his darbar. So we all are grateful to the contribution of His Highness 4th Vijayarama Gajapati Raju for giving this learning education platform to all of us. Thank you. Jai Hind.
मन्त्रेऽसीतु विजयदेवे दैवज्ञे भेषजे गुरौ यादृशी भावना यस्या सिद्धिः भवति तादृशी स्वदेशे पूज्यते राजा विद्वान् सर्वत्र पूज्येत् अटुवन्टि गोप्प विद्वान् ईरोजु मनकु मुख्य अतिथिगा इच्छेस्तू उन्नारु अटुवन्टि देशमे गर्विंचदग्ग प्रपञ्चंलोने गुर्तिंपु तेच्चुकुन्नटुवन्टि गोप्प विद्या రామానుజన్ ఈ సంవత్సరం రామానుజన్ అవార్డు గ్రహీత అయినటువంటి మన భారతదేశం గర్వించదగినటువంటి ప్రొఫెసర్ నీనా గుప్తా గారిని వేదిక మీదకు ఇచ్చేస్తున్నారు. ఆమె ప్రసంగము ఇప్పుడు ప్రారంభమవుతుంది. ఆమె గురించి మన కళాశాల విద్యార్థిని లహరి పరిచయ వాక్యాలు చెబుతున్నది.
వెరీ గుడ్ ఆఫ్టర్నూన్ ఆల్ ద ఆడియన్స్. Now I request a very important guest of this evening, Professor Deena Gupta Madam. Deena Gupta ji, you are welcome to this very great audience. We are from the MR Government Sanskrit College inviting you. Before your talk, I would like to invite my student, Sai Lahari, to introduce you, madam. Thank you very much for joining, despite of all your busy schedule. Thank you.
Gurur Brahma, Gurur Vishnu, Gurur Deva Maheshwara, Gurur Sakshat Parabrahma, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha.
Hi, a pleasant good evening all of you. I am P. Sai Lahari, studying first PGC in MR Government Sanskrit College, Vijayanagar. Today I am privileged to introduce Professor Deena Gupta, a mathematician and a professor at the Indian Statistical Institute in Kolkata, has been awarded the Ramanujan Prize 2021. Ramanujan Prize was first awarded in 2005. It is given to researchers less than 45 years of age from developing countries in the field of mathematics. The prize is named after Indian mathematician Srinivas Ramanujan. Has been recognized for her commendable work in commutative algebra and affine algebraic geometry, especially for solving Jurisky's cancellation problem. The Jurisky's cancellation problem is one of the world's greatest mathematical problems. It is the fundamental problem in algebraic geometry. In 2009, when Deena was a PhD student at the Indian Statistical Institute, she introduced her idea to crack Jurisky's cancellation problem to her professor. But her professor advised her to drop the solution to the drop idea and call it a waste of time. In 2012, she found a workable solution to the problem and won the Indian National Science Academy Medal for Young Scientist for the same in 2014. In an interaction with the Indian Today, Deena said mathematics is not as unlike other subjects, one can't memorize and no one can spoon feed you. If your concept is clear, even you can solve the problem. Practice is the key. There is no other mantra. The more you practice, the more your mind will open up. Once you start doing it, it will start generating your interest and you will fall in love. What happens is then you get scared, you start ignoring it. When asked about her future plans, Deena said that this is not the end. Instead, it is beginning. She said that there are many unsolved problems in the world of mathematics. I need to teach my students and learn from them. One needs to keep learning. There is no end to it. Said Gupta. Deena completed her PhD in 2011. In commutative algebra, under the guidance of Amartya Kumar Gupta, she told her father that she needed 5 years to complete her PhD. But like her father believed, she completed it within 2 years only. Deena studied at Kolkata High School in Dunlop, Kolkata. She studied Bachelor of Science in Mathematics at Bethune College, Kolkata. Later, she completed her Master's and PhD in Mathematics from the Indian Statistical Institute, Kolkata, where she works as a professor now. In several media interactions, Deena mentioned that her family is really supportive. She and her family are proud to this achievement. Here, the world eagerly waiting to listen inspirational lecture of you. So, now I would like to welcome the proud of India, Professor Deena Gupta, on to the virtual dialogue.
Madam, now the stage is open for you. We welcome you, madam. Professor Deena Gupta, madam.
బయటికి రావట్లేదు ఆవిడ మాట్లాడుతుంది వాళ్ళు మాట్లాడినారు కదా సార్ అగండి
హలో
వాళ్ళు రావాలి
लेकिन నేను ఇంతకు చెప్పాను కదా ఒకే
లో బస్ సార్ ఆప్ లోగ పతా బా
దో ఇన్ని చార్ యాసి దాని
పారే am i audible
yeah yeah sir you are audible
yeah
yes madam we can go ahead
मुझे बहुत खुशी हुई आप लोग ने मुझे निमंत्रण दिया और मुझे इस मंच पे आज बुलाया मुझे बहुत खुशी हुई है जानकर आप लोग अपने संस्कृति को हमारे कल्चर को अभी भी संभाल रखे हुए इतने अच्छे तरह से टुडे मिस डे इज अ नेशनल मेरी आवाज इको हो रही है सो आई गेस देयर इज अ मैकेनिज्म टू अवॉइड द इको आई डोंट नो So I'm now presenting my screen. I suppose it's visible to everyone. Hello.
No, it is
visible. Am I audible?
Yes,
ma'am. Yeah. It is visible also. Your screen is also visible.
Yes, audible, ma'am.
Yeah. So it's a National Mathematics Day and as you people have already mentioned about Srinivas S. Ramanujan is a birth anniversary and so before I begin my actual talk I just wanted to mention a few landmark results means where Ramanujan has his impacts so we all know Ramanujan has created very good beautiful mathematics he has thousands of results in his bag and in many of this he has been the creator so he is the creator of this analytic number theory this elliptic functions this 16th century this not 1916 Ramanujan discovered this Ramanujan tau function which is now central to this modular theory modular forms and which has led to Weyl's conjecture and many important discoveries have come out of this discovery of Srinivas Ramanujan we all come to know miss we all can miss try to get an idea of its genius this majesty of Ramanujan by looking at the letter of Hardy so which probably is well known the letter of Hardy where he has praised Ramanujan but I would say this letter of Hardy was highly underestimated miss Hardy has had almost no idea of how great how big this Ramanujan was just to give you an idea miss I will first begin the talk with quoting a few miss few words which great mathematicians of this 20th and 21st centuries have said it's not my words Freeman Dyson had mentioned that Ramanujan had worked so much and he has left so much results unproved he has just mentioned the theorems which will probably be a work for a century to come in another great mathematician selberg is one of the well known greatest mathematician of the 20th century he was a fields medalist in 1950 and an honorary Abel prize in 2002 selberg is saying that Ramanujan has played a very important role in the development of his as a mathematician and you just see the words which Selberg is saying about Ramanujan that it gave the impetus which started my own mathematical work so this book of Ramanujan and what he is praising that Ramanujan's actual talent was an algebraic and combinatorial nature whereas this Hardy was more of analysis type and he had only seen the analysis part of Ramanujan but this he probably had no opportunity to appreciate this algebraic and combinatorial nature of Ramanujan and when he is mentioning that Ramanujan has acquired an extraordinary skill of manipulation of algorithms series continued fractions and so forth which certainly is completely unequaled in modern times Selberg further means we all know that Ramanujan has a series of notebooks four notebooks which was full of theorems and many of them means of course most of them are without proof they are just statements and they were a group of mathematicians who studied Ramanujan's
notebook.
Who studied Ramanujan's notebook, and they discovered Ramanujan's result one after another. And so you see what Aladi is saying. Ramanujan's work is more fundamental than Hardy had ever imagined. Selberg says that it would take more than a decade, possibly more than a century, to fully understand Ramanujan's contribution. Akshay, he's saying, again, miss this work of Ramanujan, from where he got those ideas, from where he is writing those theorems, they were just marvelous, but they have no idea from where he is getting all these results. So even, and similar such statements were made by many mathematicians, that how Ramanujan arrived at those statements. I will not get into those comments of so many people, but I would like to mention about Ken Uno. Ken Uno, in an interview which was published in Bhavana. Bhavana is a journal which is begin in 2017, and in the inaugural issue of Bhavana, this Ken Uno has published an interview of Ken Uno was published. So Ken Uno is behind, he has developed a theory which had, he's mentioning that there's a one of the work of Ramanujan, which Ken Uno had worked, the Japanese mathematician, and that had led to some discoveries in black holes. So you can see the impact of Ramanujan. But what Ken Uno was saying, that how Ramanujan has inspired a group of Japanese to pursue mathematics. So when this is a story, a small story, which after the Second World War, after this Hiroshima and Nagasaki's attack, Japan was in a very pathetic state. There was almost nothing in Japan. People were starving. There was no food. And in that pathetic condition, there was an attempt from all over the world to revive Japan, to bring Japan back into life. And in that revivation, one of this attempt was to hold conferences, mathematical conferences or scientific conferences, so that... bring Japan back into action. So there was a conference in 1955 where one of the famous 20th century mathematicians, American mathematician Andrew Wiles, was present. And Andrew Wiles, on that day, that night, he is giving a speech to this Japanese students. And let me tell you, the students, they are hungry. They are hungry for knowledge, but they almost have no food. So they are hungry for knowledge as well as for food. On that night, when put up this quote from Ken Uno, he is saying that on that night, while told the starving Japanese about this mysterious Indian genius, he told them about Ramanujan. There is no wonder now that so many Japanese mathematicians have gone on to study mathematics inspired by Ramanujan. They learned about Ramanujan at that very meeting where they found their own home. So you can see. Not only people in India, but even all over the world, the impact he has on the life of others. He now, Mr. Ken Uno, is quoting the one of the most series of notable discoveries in the 21st century, 20th century, and out of which there were many important discoveries, whether it's the Delling's proofs of the Wells conjecture, or it is the solution of the Gauss's class number problem by Gottfeld, or whether it's the Wiles proof of the Fermat's last theorem, or is it Borchardt's work of the infinite product of expansion of automorphic forms. But so these were some notable discoveries of the 20th century. And if you closely look at this work, then you will see that everywhere there is an impact of Ramanujan. And And if a proper assessment of Ramanuja's great means must then take into account with the remarkable fact that his work makes intimate contact with all of these notable achievements. Clearly, Ramanujam was a great anticipator. His work provided examples and suggested important questions which are now inescapable in the paradigm of modern number theory. So with this, we all pay our tribute to Srinivas Ramanujan, who, as you see, is a role model. This is a god for most of the mathematicians and people here who are pursuing research, and his impact. I thought of giving a very brief account of polynomials, its genesis, and some brief small results, few results, which we all probably know. And so this is just a brief introduction. So, but before that, just one small quote of William Blake. He says that to see the world in a grain of sand and a heaven in a wild flower, hold infinity in you, the palm of your hand, and eternity in an hour. So this is just a phrase, world in a grain of sand. So what is a great man does? A great man can see the whole world in just one grain of sand. And this is what great people like Brahmagupta, Gauss, Newton, they have been doing. And just an illustration of this fact is our decimal system. So decimal system of writing numbers, you people would be knowing it much better because you are reading Sanskrit literature. So it was there in our Vedic times. So, but this decimal system is so sophisticated mathematics, and it has made our life so simple that we sometimes ignore, we sometimes don't realize that how difficult and how sophisticated this decimal system has been. So it has made the life so simple that we can get it introduced in our curriculum right in KG, this kindergarten school. We can introduce this decimal system, but it is highly a sophisticated piece of mathematics. It would be highly unimaginable to think about a world where we would not have got this decimal system, this counting system had not been there. But have we ever thought that what is the mathematical principle behind this decimal system expansion of numbers? So the mathematical principle is that you can write any natural number as a polynomial in the power of 10. So if where a0, a1, an, they are natural numbers lying between 0 to 9. So for instance, you can write this year 2021 as 2 into 10 to the power 3 plus 2 into 10 plus 1. So this way of writing any natural number in form of a decimal system, so this is writing it as a polynomial. So this was the genesis of how these polynomials have begun, and this inspires the concept of polynomials. We can see, so polynomials and power series. So what is a polynomial? A polynomial is an expression of this form which is introduced in our schools itself. So it's where a0, a1, an, you can take it from any system of numbers. It can be real numbers, complex numbers, doesn't matter. And with this x as a polynomial in X, which is an unknown quantity. So it's a finite sum like this, and a power series and an infinite sum, which does not have an end term. So in power series, I don't talk about convergence. So this polynomials and power series, they are the natural generalization of decimal system. You just replace X by 10. And they are very central objects to mathematics as natural numbers. We cannot think about mathematics without numbers, so we cannot think about without polynomials. Isaac Newton was a pioneer in the study of polynomials and power series, and so he studied it in, he discovered, rediscovered in Europe in 17th century. It was there in our history, right in the 7th century by Brahmagupta. He defined the algebra of polynomials. So by the term algebra here, I mean that on the set of all polynomials, you can add any two polynomials, you can subtract, you can multiply through polynomials, and the resulting is also again a polynomial. So adding of two polynomials or multiplication, that is an algebra operation. Plus, minus, multiplication, these are called algebra operation. And so since we were accustomed to the notion of polynomials, we could also comfortable with the power series expansions of the trigonometric functions like sin x, con x, cos x, and this was given in the 14th century by Madhava, the Indian mathematician. And our great mathematician, Professor Sri Ram S. Abhyankar. Abhyankar is a pioneer in the area of affine algebraic geometry, and we work in his area of algebraic geometry, and we inherit, we try to inherit many of his techniques of work. So he has popularized polynomials and power series. In fact, he tried to encourage mathematicians to work more and more with polynomials and power series, and he in fact wrote a poem. So this poem is quite big, but I just quote two lines: polynomials and power series, may they forever rule the world. The statement of Newton indicates that the algebra of polynomials is a conscious generalization of this idea of decimal system. The decimal system had become standard in Europe by the 17th century, and shortly just before Newton, and it is therefore natural that Newton could discover this polynomials and power series. However, in India, this number systems was presented much before. It is there in the Rig Vedas and probably in all the Vedic treatises, and this almost subsequent Indian text. So in some sense, Indians never had a problem with the decimal system, except in few instances where you find numbers with base 100, but again 100 is a multiple of 10. Therefore, it was not surprising that in India, as early as in 7th century, Brahmagupta discovered the algebra of polynomials, and Madhava discovered power series expansion of trigonometric functions. And in a quotation of Isaac Newton, he is saying that, "I was amazed that it has occurred to no one that this decimal system is a generalization of this this polynomial system is a generalization of the decimal system." And so he's saying this doctrine of species has same relation to algebra that a doctrine in decimal numbers has to common arithmetic, like its operations of addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, roots, extraction may easily be learned from the latter. And this expression of Newton, you can find it in this paper in 1671. So thus begins the study of polynomials. And again, a very common thing is the discovery of this decimal system and polynomial system in mathematics had led to other mathematical expansions, like Leibniz had discovered this binary expansion of numbers. So which this we all know, this binary expansion of numbers has its application in usage of modern computers. And like our computer system is based on this binary systems. This is a little complicated discovery of Hensel's, who discovered this periodic expansion of numbers. And this periodic expansion of numbers were a powerful tool in modern number theory, which including in the Weyl's proof of Fermat's last theorem, this periodic numbers were played a crucial role. So we have this dyadic expansions of Abhyankar's Mohr expansion technique. So Abhyankar and Mohr, as I said, Abhyankar is a very well-known, revered Indian mathematician who generalized this concept of polynomials and power series to dyadic. So G is given any polynomial, writing another polynomial in terms of G as a power series polynomial in G. So this has its application in the development of this expansion techniques. And expansion techniques had led to beautiful results in affine algebraic geometry. In fact, Abhyankar is acknowledging in a paper that a theorem of a system of generators of a summing group is basically the generalization of the idea of decimal system. And this is what, and he is therefore acknowledging, and he in fact write a chapter in his book, The Decimal Expansion. So it may appear that he is talking about something very basic, but it includes this chapter includes non-trivial results. So now I come to this some discoveries on the solutions of the polynomial equations by radical. Just one second. So given any polynomial in one variable where this coefficients a0, a1, these are something known to us, the problem is to find a formula for the roots. Roots is any solution of this equation fx is equal to 0 in terms of these known coefficients a0, a1, an, in terms of this natural mathematical operations which we are all familiar, plus, minus, multiplication, division, and taking mth root. So this radical expression. So this is something which was very natural, and probably we don't have to teach anyone what does this mean. But so that is taking any known number C, we know what does an mth root of C means. And so now let us do it step by step. So let us solve a polynomial of degree 1. Which is a linear equation, ax plus b equal to 0, and a is a non-zero number. So how to solve this? And if I ask this question, you people will just say, oh, she's asking this, it's so simple, miss, we don't know this, it's so simple. Probably she's misunderstood us that we know so much and she's asking me this question. But yes, this question may look very simple to us, but it was not so simple to, you know, even till the end of 15th century. And because I tell you the problem behind solving this, so this simple linear equations created difficulty among Arabs and European mathematicians till 14th to 15th centuries. And the difficulty was the difficulty of formalism, the formation of equation, the use of negative numbers. There was no symbol, the symbolism. But however, thankfully due to Brahmagupta, who discovered this classical algebra, he initiated the use of symbols, the formation of equations, and then, of course, we were very comfortable with negative numbers and fractions, which in Europe they were still struggling. So, solution of this is x is equal to minus b by a. So, taking a negative number and fraction, both of them were creating difficulty to Europeans, and you will see that even school-going students, they have difficulty in understanding the concept of plus, minus, and fractions. But thankfully, if they are taught well, they don't create a difficulty in the later stage. So because we were comfortable, we could solve this n equal to 1. In fact, we could even solve the quadratic equation. So quadratic equation is a degree 2 polynomial, ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0, where a is a non-zero element. So this problem was solved even in Brahmagupta, the time of Brahmagupta, where he said, in Sanskrit, he said, Madhya Harana. So that is this middle term, you just take away that middle term. So the idea is, strategy is to take away this middle term, somehow make the middle term zero. So if you take the middle term zero, then the equation is x square equal to minus c by a, and then you know how to take the square root. To take away the middle term, and then the equation will be of this form y square equal to d, where d is a rational number, and then you take the square root. And so is the Sridharacharya, he's saying the idea is complete the square. So what does he do? He just multiply this equation by 4, and then this equation with 2x plus b, that becomes a complete square. So if you do this, then you have to subtract b square and you put it on the right hand side, and this equation takes this form. And then if you substitute y is equal to 2ax plus b and d equal to b square minus 4ac, then the equation takes the form y square equal to d. So now you know how to solve this equation, and then you just immediately put y equal to square root of d. So you know y. So once you know y, you can solve x from this equation by putting the value of y here. Now this is a linear equation, and this we know how to solve. So from a quadratic equation, we moved on to a linear equation, and we know how to solve this. And this formula was explicitly stated in generality by Brahmagupta, and it was of course known to Aryabhatta, and these methods were stated by Sridharacharya, and therefore It's named after Siddharacharya. So the solution of quadratic equation is known to us. So the idea is to eliminate the middle term. So this eliminating the middle term, this idea, this strategy has been applicable to even other difficult problems in the mathematics, advanced problem. Let me give you a few instances. Like this is a general n degree polynomial. If you put this substitution y equal to x plus b1 by n, then this coefficient of x to the power n minus 1 becomes 0. So that this idea of killing, this in fact, this is not my quotation, it's Abhyankar who is saying that, that killing of b1 was the basic trick underlying Zariski's and Hironaka's proof of resolution of singularities of algebraic varieties of characteristic 0. So this algebraic varieties of this resolution of singularities is a very big problem for which Hironaka got the Fields Medal. So that, and the basic trick was this Madhyaharana, that is you eliminate, take out this B1, so which Abhyankar is quoting. So Abhyankar calls in his own proof that a certain proof of a theorem of Newton is actually a Siddharacharya's proof, follows from Siddharacharya's, this idea of killing the middle term. So this is something which we can take up from this solving a quadratic equation as a general mathematical strength. Means this is where this, I can quote this poem of Blake that he can see the world in a grain of sand. So even in this simple solution of quadratic equation, you take out something which is very powerful in proving major problems in mathematics. Now we come to this cubic polynomial. So a cubic polynomial is a degree 3 polynomial where A, B, C, D are known natural numbers. Now the problem is, can you solve this? So how do you solve this? So as we have learned from this linear polynomial or quadratic polynomial, is that we will eliminate the, try to get rid of this coefficient of x square, and we try to solve some polynomial of lower degree. So this is something which we take in the spirit of Siddharacharya, completing the square, and therefore we make this substitution y is equal to 3ax plus b. So once I make this substitution, this polynomial reduces to this form y cube plus equal to py plus q. So this is where we inherit, means we try to learn from what our ancestors have done and try to see them. So this is research. Search from already, means do a, means revisiting what has already been done. So from there, they from this cubic polynomial, they have reduced it to a polynomial which is slightly simple looking, but it's not so simple looking because this coefficient of y is still present. So if y coefficient of y is 0, you just take the cube root and you have been able to solve it. But this coefficient of y, now we don't know what to do. So the coefficient of y square is absent, but the coefficient of y is still present. And we have not achieved what we wanted. We wanted it to be of this form y cube equal to 1. And we are not able to do this, so I don't know what to do. So here probably this looking at what earlier mathematicians have done will not help, and a new idea is required. So the solving a cubic equation, an original idea was there which was provided by Cardano. So he thought the root of this equation y cube equal to py plus q is just not one element, it's a sum of two elements. So the root will be of the form u plus v, where u and v are some numbers. And for solving this, so he assumed that the root is sum of two numbers, and he put it in this equation as u plus v. And then he realized that now once you put this, then u cube plus v cube is equal to q. And from this u plus v, this coefficient is 3uv is equal to p. So you get two equations, and if you substitute value of v is equal to p by 3u in this equation, then you get a quadratic equation in u cube. And by symmetry, you can see v cube is also a root of this equation. And therefore, now we were originally working with a polynomial of degree 3. So this has reduced to a polynomial of degree 2 now, quadratic equation, which you know how to solve. And once you solve this quadratic equation, you know the value of u cube and you know the value of v cube. And hence, you know what is u and v because you just take the cube root. And then you know what is the value of y, which is u plus v. Yes? Is there any questions?
No, ma'am. Please continue.
No, madam. Please continue.
So now what we have in our hand is that y is u plus v, where u cube and v cube are roots of this quadratic equation. Quadratic equation we know how to solve. So the root of this quadratic equation is q by 2 plus minus q by 2 whole square minus p by 3 whole cube. Now, therefore, the cube roots of u cube and v cube will be the cube root of this, this number. If I call this u, then the other roots will be omega u and omega square u. And so the value of v will be this number minus of that. This is plus, this is minus, omega v and omega square u. So in this, we have got three values for u and three values for v. So if I look at this combination u plus v, we overall have 9 combinations. But we will not take all the 9 combinations, is not allowed, because there is a restriction that the product of u and v is a rational number. Therefore, not all possible combinations are needed. You only need u plus v, omega u plus omega square v and omega v. So this is product of these two is a rational number. And hence, this is a solution. And the root actually looks like the sum of two numbers u plus v. So these are the three roots of the cubic equation. After solving this cubic equation, the solutions were given by many Italian mathematicians, Del Ferraro, Tartaglia, and Cardano. So I illustrated the Cardano's method. So this was the first major mathematical achievement in the modern Europe, and which was completely unknown to the ancient scientists. And the 16th century mathematicians primarily their mathematical work were assimilation of what ancient Greek and Indian mathematicians and their systematization and extension. And this solution to this cubic equation was most original work of the 16th century, and which may have contributed to the spirit of Renaissance. So Renaissance in 16th century led to the invention of printing, fall of Constantinople, birth of Leonardo Vinci, and so on. Now I come to the quartic equation, polynomial of degree 4. So how to solve a polynomial of degree 4? So as I said, we need to keep on learning from our ancestors. So we first try to apply Sridharacharya type of transformation and reduce this problem to a problem like this, where this coefficient of y cube is absent. Now, after applying this Sridharacharya trick, we try to complete the square. So there is y4 plus y square. So if I try to complete, I will get something like this. But still, this is something. Had it this term of y is not present, that means this minus q is 0, you would easily take a square root and you will know how to solve the equation. But this coefficient of y is present. So now something new is required. So an original trick was there required, which needed something. So the trick was try to do some manipulation, some contribution to add some number here so that this your right hand side also becomes a perfect square. So this was a trick. And so what is that number which I need to add? So suppose this is the number z, which is an unknown quantity. I added it on both sides. So then this z square, so I have to add z square plus p times z plus y square, 2zy square. So I added it on the both side. Now I assume that the value of z is such that your right hand side is a perfect square. Now you just note that right hand side, for this to be a perfect square, so this is a quadratic in y, that discriminant, that b square minus 4ac, that must be 0. So for this to have a perfect square, what is the discriminant of this? So discriminant of this is nothing but this coefficient of y, which is q square equal to 4ac, c is 2z, that is becomes 8z, and then c is p square minus 4 by 4 plus pz plus z square. So you have to choose z such that this happens. Now what is this? If you carefully look at it, it is a cubic polynomial in z. now we were on the beginning, we wanted to solve a fourth degree polynomial. So from there, we have reduced the problem to a 3-degree polynomial. So that we have reduced it to a cubic polynomial, and we know how to solve a cubic polynomial. So from here, we can find the value of z. Then this both right-hand side and left-hand side will become a perfect square, and square we can cancel, take plus minus, and then we can probably solve it. So this is how a quartic polynomial equation is solved. So you add z, and therefore where z is this number, suppose we have already solved it, then your right-hand side is y square, left-hand side is y square plus p by 2 plus z whole square, and the left-hand side, right-hand side becomes sy plus t, which are known quantities, and then you take the square root, and now you can solve for y. So this quantic equation were solved by Ferrari, who was came to Cardano at the age of 14 as a servant. He learned mathematics and developed into a mathematician, and Cardano's friend and secretary. So in each of these preceding methods, what we have seen is that when you are solving a polynomial of a certain degree, you are reducing the problem to solve a polynomial of a lower degree. So from a 4-degree polynomial, you were reduced to solve it to a degree 3. From degree 3, you were reduced to a polynomial of degree 2. And degree 2, you were reduced to a polynomial of degree 1. So this was a general way which was there common in all the problems. And what was the methods involved? Mastery of the previous knowledge and tricks, skills in applying them, and an original idea. And for a general polynomial equation of nth degree, now the question is, can you generalize this idea to a polynomial of a general polynomial of nth degree for n greater than or equal to 5? Is it possible to form an auxiliary equation of lower degree? Yes, is it possible? No significant breakthrough was happening for next 225 years after 1545. And the solution of a second, third, and fourth degree equation by Siddharacharya, Cardano, and Ferrari appears to be separate problems which have its own features. Several attempts were made to solve the fifth degree polynomial by very distinguished mathematicians like Waite, Descartes, Swinhouse, Euler, Bizot, Vandermonde, and they described new ways of solving this polynomials of cubic and quartic polynomials, but they could not achieve any breakthrough in the fifth degree polynomial. Just let me illustrate an idea of Vandermonde. So a quadratic polynomial will be of this form, x minus x1 into x minus x2. And what are the roots? Roots will be this equation. So what is this? X1 plus x2 plus minus. So this is just a simple way of writing x1 and x2. This is generally a simple way of writing x1 and x2. But if you carefully look at what is x1 plus x2, x1 plus x2 will be the coefficient of x. And this x1 minus x2 whole square, this will be b square minus 4ac. So that is this quadratic term. So you're writing this expression root as a sum of two elements like this, and where this term x1 minus x2. So, great mathematician, I am too small, I cannot think like this. A great mathematician like Vandermonde, he can think it like, it's not x1 minus x2. He think that it is like x1 plus minus 1 of x2, where this coefficient 1 and minus 1 are the two square roots of 1. And you may be thinking that why I am saying all this. It's so simple, but it's related. Means he is trying to see a common phenomena, general phenomena, of all the roots of a general n degree polynomial. So he came up with this idea that if n is a prime number and rho 1, rho 2, rho n are the nth roots of unity, then his question is whether the general equation of n degree is whether the roots will be of this form. So whether the roots of a general equation of degree n, whether it will look like this. So this was a quadratic equation which was true for n equal to 2. So this question has a solution for n equal to 2, whether it has an affirmative solution in higher degree. So this, he posed this problem, and Abel in 1813, he realized that if at all there is a general formula for solving a polynomial of nth degree, and if at all there is a formula for writing the roots, then it must be of this form. And he also proved that it is not possible for n greater than or equal to 5. So in schools and colleges, we are only taught how to solve a quartic polynomial, but we have never taught how to solve a fifth degree polynomial or higher degree polynomial. Because the fact which a mathematician can only prove that there is no way, there is no formula which you can use it for solving an nth degree polynomial. There is no general way for solving a polynomial of degree n. And this had led to, even Ruffini gave incomplete proofs, but there was already in the hindsight that maybe there is no general formula for solving a fifth degree polynomial or higher degree polynomial. Let me just give you an instance of symmetric functions. So we all know this symmetric functions. If I write x, a polynomial in x with roots x1, x2, xn, then if you expand it, it will look like this, where s1, s2, sn are this sum of this elementary symmetric functions. And Newton, he had this insight, he discovered that any symmetric polynomial in x1, x2, xn is a polynomial of the form g is a polynomial in s1, s2, sn. So this was the discovery of Newton, and Waring in fact said how to explicitly determine G. So Waring actually gave you a way of algorithm, quick way of constructing the G. Lagrange was one of the most notable mathematician in 18th century. He examined all the solutions of this polynomial equations of quadratic and cubic and quartic. He studied all of them and he tried to understand, try to abstract some general pattern or procedure. What is there? He had this great realization that these problems may look independent, but there must be a common way of understanding. There must be some general principle which one has to understand, which is behind the solution of all these problems. And he discovered this Lagrange resolvent. I will not get into that. So this vigorous search for the general principle heralded a new attitude in mathematics, leading to the birth of modern abstract algebra, which led to the birth of group theory, field theory, ring theory, and which led to this study of higher mathematics, which Galois discovered within. And I personally regret a lot that I don't know is whatever I learned, I just come to an end and saying that I have not it's far away from my understanding the subject and something of the great leading principles of mathematics which Charles Darwin has said. And with this I stop. I have not getting into the higher mathematics, which is something for you people to find out and read yourself. And I just end up with a beautiful quote of Bertrand Russell, who is talking about the ultimate beauty of mathematics. Thank you.
Thank you very much, madam. Yes, I would like to, maybe my students would like to give you a standing ovation, madam, for your greatest achievement. Yes. Madam, it is entire India, particularly representing our college, all our students are giving a standing ovation for you, madam, for your greatest achievement, particularly this Ramanujan Award, Ramanujan Prize for 2021. Really, your message to the young population, young people, particularly the girl students here, they would like to ask only one question, madam. Because it is the language of equation is almost Ramanujan said that is the language of God. And in this background, you already achieved that. If Ramanujan knows the language of infinity among women and among representing the girls, you are the person who knows the infinity about this entire universe. Only small, maybe our students want to interact with you.
So, so if you have any question.
Yeah, one, one question, madam.
Madam,
how do you use followers in your daily life, madam?
How do we?
How to use polynomials in daily life?
No, see, polynomials are there everywhere, right? Means you in day-to-day life, if you are solving something, you will, the formation of polynomials are already there, right? Means we never realize it, but it's there. This is taught in school days. So finding an unknown quantity, it will be satisfying some equation. Whether it's linear or non-linear, I don't know, but forming polynomials is very simple. This is there always.
Thank you, madam. In Andhra, the Telugu person says that about algebra, it is a gundegabra. Gundegabra means there is a palpitation in heart when we think about algebra.
Yes.
But you made it Dilka Dadkan, madam. Really, we appreciate you from bottom of my heart. It is a standing ovation once again. Thank you for your valuable time and sharing all that with us, madam. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, madam. Now I invite Dr. R. Devakumar Garu, joint director, who is a very experienced mathematician from the University of Hyderabad. He is the joint director, CCA, and also a great mathematician. I invite Tarwane to introduce Dr. Devakumar Garu. Thank you, madam.
Thank you very much.
Pujantam Rama Rameti Madhuram Madhuraksharam Arahya Kavita Saka Vande Valmiki Kokilam Vande Valmiki Kokilam. Good evening, everyone. Let me introduce myself. I am an Common Study Selvani from First POL, studying at M.R. Government Sanskrit College, Vijayanagaram. I am proud and privileged to introduce an eminent personality, R. David Kumar Swami, Honorable Joint Director of Commissionerate of Collegiate Education, Andhra Pradesh. He is working as Principal of Government Degree College, Rasmandi, since 24th August 2016. He has held various positions in academic and administrative fields, and he has pursued his PhD in Mathematics from University of Hyderabad in 1997. He has been expertised in the area of specification and global analysis and its applications. He has made numerous professional contributions through writing research publications. He has been acting as a panel member of the Mathematical Reviews at an editorial committee of American Mathematical Society since November 2005. He has been awarded with UGC Teacher Fellowship during 1994 to 1995 by the University Grants Commission, Government of India for 1 year. He has played a pivotal role in the establishment of Johor Knowledge Centers and trained 1.5 lakh students across the state and employable skills. As an academic guidance officer at the CCE employable skills, at the CCE Andhra Pradesh initiated and implemented various academic activities in the state of higher education institutions. He has acted as a chief editor for the college magazine, Yoran, published by the students and staff of the Department of Computer Science at Government Degree College, Jammukundi for the year 2002 to 2003. With his tireless efforts, Government Degree College, Rajahmundry has been as the first college that secured NAC A+ grading across India. He has also chosen 1729, the Ramanujan number, that shows his regards towards Srinivas Ramanujan and love towards mathematics. Thank you, everyone. We are looking forward to hearing the message from our Honorable JD sir.
Sir, welcome, sir. The dais is open for you. You are not audible, sir.
Sir, unmute chestunnaru.
Okay, am I audible?
Yeah. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah, thank you, Dr. Anil, the principal of the college, and my dear students, and other delegates who are participating this webinar. So I congratulate, first of all, I congratulate the college management, the principal, and the team.
And also, please, nice. Professor Neela Gupta madam is also there.
The team members and Professor Neela Gupta, who is a Ramanujan awardee, and I have listened to his lecture today. It's a wonderful talk on polynomials. And other delegates who are participating this webinar. So my talk on this occasion, first of all, I wish everybody my greetings on the eve of the National Mathematics Day celebrations, the birth anniversary of Srinivasa Ramanujan. So he's a great mathematician. So once again, greetings to all the students. So my talk today, it will be very brief. I don't talk anything, any mathematics, but the only thing is, I wanted to discuss the Srinivasa Ramanujan is a great mathematician, an Indian mathematician. From Indian side, he's a great mathematician, right? So my very first, my talk is completely on solving mathematical problems. A small history. Solving mathematical problems. So who does this? A mathematician. So my question is, who is a mathematician? How does he solve problems? So that's only my very fundamental question. Who is a mathematician? How does he solve problems, he or she, right? So on this, just we go, it's a completely a general talk. It will be, I think, for the coming generations, you all should know about this, right? You should be aware of it. So I'll give a small presentation. I'll just present. So is it visible, Mr. Dr. Anil?
You are visible, sir. Presentation is not visible.
Presentation is not visible. Okay, yes. One second.
Sir, arrow click cheyandi. Up here, I don't know. Arrow, sir.
Up arrow.
Is it visible, my presentation?
No, sir, not it. You just click on that arrow, down arrow. Click on.
Just once again.
WhatsApp sent you some
answer. Upper arrow is there now, present now.
Yes. Please click on that.
Yeah, I have clicked that. A window or entire screen? Window.
Yes,
sir. Window. I need a window open. Sir, window open.
సార్ ఎంట్రన్స్ స్క్రీన్ అయితే మీ డెస్క్టాప్ అంతా ప్రెజెంట్ అవుతుంది మీరు విండో
పెట్టుకోండి ఇస్ ఇట్ ఓకే
కవలస్ ఎస్ సార్
ఇస్ ఇట్ ఓకే
ఎస్ సార్ యు ఆర్ ప్రెజెంట్
హియరింగ్ మై ప్రెజెంటేషన్
యా నౌ ఇట్ ఇస్ ఓకే సార్ ఇట్స్ ఫైన్
యా Okay. So my today's presentation is solving mathematical problems. It's a completely general talk, and it should be useful to the students. You can aware of this. You can just make some small observations. So my question is, who will solve mathematical problems? So mathematician. So mathematician will solve mathematical problems, right? So mathematical problems generally arise from day to day. So based on that, the mathematician will attempt to solve the mathematical problems, right? So for that, the very first question is, who is a mathematician and how does he solve problems? So mathematician, I'm giving a definition. So it is a completely abstract definition. It's a completely abstract definition. A mathematician, who is a mathematician? Generally, different people will say different, many definitions for that. Who is a mathematician? Who does mathematics? A mathematician who does mathematics? Who solve problems? Like that. But who is really a mathematician in the terms of the abstract sense? Who is a mathematician is a blind person. So blind, I don't mean that no eyes. It's not like that. So please, careful. That's why I told you very clearly it's an abstract definition. A mathematician is a blind person sitting in a dark room. It doesn't mean that, I don't mean that he is sitting in a dark room where there is no light. It's not like that. So sitting in a dark room. So generally a dark room doesn't, you can't see anything, right? Sitting in a dark room and searching for a black cat. Searching for a black cat. So in a dark room, can you see the black cat? Maybe you should try it. So searching for a black cat. So please note the words black cats, black cat. Right? He is searching for a black cat. He's sitting in a dark room, searching for a black cat, which is not there. So this is the definition of a mathematician. Generally, an abstract definition. Many of you also maybe knows this definition, right? So a mathematician is a blind person sitting in a dark room searching for a black cat. So now I'll tell you, so what are these black cats? How does they solve problems? For when you try to make attempt to solve a problem, you will come across these black cats. So black cats will be created by a mathematician. That's all. So let us go with some kind of history in the elementary stages. So in the elementary stages, when you are in the school, school mathematics, just I'm talking about here, in the school mathematics. So assuming in the elementary stages, the natural number system, 1, 2, 3, 4, so on. That is the only we are having the domain. Only domain availability is only 1, 2, 3, 4, so on. That is natural numbers. Now, in this domain, I wanted to solve some problems. Some problems. So for example, if you want to solve the equations like this, a linear equation like this, Lx plus m is equal to n, where L, m, n are natural numbers. That means L must be either in this domain, m and n also must be in this domain. Now my question is, the mathematician has a question that does this equation have a solution in this domain, in the same domain? That means whatever the solution for x must be in the natural numbers. So it's not always possible. For example, L is equal to 1, M is equal to 1, N is equal to 1 if you take. Then what is the equation? X plus 1 is equal to 1. Then we know now if you want to solve this problem, this equation, then x must be 0. Is 0 is there in the natural numbers? No. So that is a black cat the mathematician has created. So that is a zero. So zero is a black cat. So while solving this equation, while you come across solving this equation, the mathematician has to create some black cats like zero and negative integers also. For example, L is equal to 1, M is equal to 2, N is equal to 1. X plus 2 is equal to 1, suppose. Then X must be minus 1. So minus 1 is not there in this domain. So this equation is not finding solutions in the domain. So this domain will be expanded now. The domain is expanded because for solving this equation, you have to create some black cats like zero and negative integers. And therefore, you are forming the G, the integer set. So like this, some other equations come across. So problems. Then you will find out, you will come up with rational numbers. You can name equations. Like this, in the elementary stages, the mathematician has created black cats like zeros, negative integers, rational numbers, irrational numbers, like that. If you come to the higher stages, polynomial equations. The polynomial equations could not be solved for roots until and after the real number system or complex number system are created. So for example, if you take the polynomial equations like x square is equal to 2, for example, is a polynomial equation. Suppose you take x square is equal to 2, then x must be plus or minus root 2. So it is a rational number and it's a real number, right? It should be in. So unless to solve the polynomial equations could not be solved unless you create the real number system and complex number system. Even x square is equal to some other, if we take some equation, then you will come across the complex numbers for solutions, right? So similarly, the field of complex numbers is also ultimate domain to achieve the two things, that is solving polynomial equations and make Cauchy sequence converge. This is at the higher stages analysis in the solving equations, right? So in the elementary stages, the black cats are created. In the higher stages, if you solve polynomial equations, black cats must be created. So that's what the mathematician does. So now, if you look at the first degree equations, so what is the first degree equations? First degree, they're linear equations. The second degree equations, quadratic, for example, quadratic equation, ax squared plus bx plus c equal to 0 is a quadratic equation. You know how to find its roots, minus b plus r minus root of something, something y divided by something, right? We know the quadratic equation in the lower stages. Similarly, if you come to the third degree equations, that is cubic equations. The cubic equations solved by cubic polynomial solved by the Cardan, the great mathematician. Right? The Cardan is a great mathematician. He gave solutions for that. And the fourth, next problem for the mathematician is the fourth degree. The fourth degree also solved by the Ferrari, the great mathematician. Now the fifth degree equations, fifth degree polynomials, fifth degree. So there comes the very interesting story. In the fifth degree polynomials, this person, the great mathematician Galois. So he's a student of university, he's a student of mathematics, and he created black cats and he solved the fifth degree polynomials. Right? I'm just stealing the polynomial equation, solvability of polynomial equations by radicals. That is done after that. But this young boy is named Galois. He's a Jew. Boy is a Jew. And 1811 to 1832. So not more than 21 years he died. Right? So he created black cats and he has solved the polynomial equations by radicals. And that is a big history is there. Galois, why he died just before 21 years, just below 21 years. Very young boy, studied mathematics in USA, Central America, and then but his mathematics was not accepted. He found his mathematics, right? Fifth degree polynomial equations, but it was not accepted by the then friend journal. It's not accepted. So for this, he was almost, he joined in a terrorist group. That's what history says. The Galois joined in a terrorist group when French Revolution is taking place during that time in the Paris. So he joined in that French revolutionary group and he was killed on the streets of Paris. Was killed on the streets of Paris because he's a terrorist. So there ends matter. So later after 15 years of the death of Galois, the Lully has come, and then he understood the theory, whatever he discovered, he created, that understood by Lully, and then he solved all the theorems of Galois, and he made it a Galois theory, right? It's a group theory. Our degree students and PG students, we study at degree level, very elementary level group theory they study. That is actually the main creator for the group theory is Galois. That's what mathematics history says, right? So, but there are three important great mathematicians who played a very dominant key role before the death of Galois. So because the death happens because of these three mathematicians, that is Cauchy, Fourier, and Poisson. These are the three great mathematicians. So during this period, maybe it is 1830s, just because 1830s or maybe 1828, like that, during that time, the Cauchy is the greatest mathematician in the world. Cauchy's sequence, Cauchy's convergence, right? Cauchy. So Cauchy is the greatest mathematician at that time, and then his research work was sent to Cauchy for evaluation, because he is a referee. But Cauchy is the greatest mathematician. He is moving around the world, and he could not find time. He has not seen the work, and almost he passed the time. So again, the journal, the French journal, they asked Cauchy. Then he said, "I am very busy. I am very busy. I could not see his work." So then again, it was sent to Fourier, is another referee. Again, Fourier, he understood everything, but he maybe on the next day, in the next coming meeting, he wants to present the Galois theory. But he died with heart attack. That's what the history says. So again, it is over. So in the meanwhile, when Cauchy acted as a referee, and then again the journal editor asked Galois to please resubmit your work again. Again, he resubmitted. And at that time, they don't have Xerox machines or computers. Nothing is there at that time, right? Again, he has written with his own handwriting, and then. And similarly, Fourier has evaluated, but Fourier died. So that papers, whatever he has submitted, they are also gone. Again, the editor has asked Galois, please resubmit. So at that time, Galois has written his entire theory again, once again, hundreds of pages. And in many places, he has written the theorem statement, proof, no time to give proof, because he was frustrated. By the time he was in frustration. And then it was sent to Poisson, his great mathematician. Then Poisson submitted a report as a referee that the Galois work is incomprehensible, because the entire work is a lot of gaps are there that they could not understand. I think so. So that's why it is incomprehensible. So that was kept in Attaka, right? It was thrown away, right? And the Galois work was rejected, and then he came out of it. And Galois joined in a French Revolution group. He was died. So there ends matter. That's why Galois lived for only 21 years. Right? After 15 years, the Galois theory has come out because of Lully, great mathematician. He's also a student. and then he has understood every work of Galois, and then he proved all the theorems and he has declared it's a Galois theory. It's a group theory, Galois theory, whatever. So that's why Galois is a great mathematician. And also I wanted to present one more great mathematician. One more great mathematician, that's Fermat. Fermat's last theorem. The Fermat is also has made lot many in the number theory, lot many theorems he has proved. And yes, in the last theorem, the Fermat's last theorem is this x power n plus y power n is equal to z power n. This is the equation, x to the power of n plus y to the power of n plus z to the power of n in 1638. During the year 1638, he made this statement. He lived for 65 years. He's a French mathematician. And he made this statement, x power n plus y power n is equal to z power n, has no integer solution for n greater than or equal to 3. If the n value is 3, this equation has no integer solution. Suppose n is equal to 1, x plus y is equal to z, yes. We can have the integer solutions. X is equal to 1, y is equal to 1, z is equal to 2, like that. If n is equal to 2, x square plus y square is equal to z square. It's a Pythagoras theorem. It has a solution, right? N is equal to 3, this equation has no solution, no integer solution. That's what he made a statement. So this was kept for not proved, no solution for 350 years. No solution for 350 years. So even when I was in school education, when I was in school, I born in 1963. In my school education, in my school books, even up to 90s, right? In our school education, in 8th, 6th class, 7th class, this Fermat's last theorem was mentioned in school books. And then they say it has no algorithm. It has no proof. It has no algorithm, no solution. So this was kept for long years. Many great mathematicians, even Cauchy, these people also made attempt. Great mathematicians of 16th century, 17th century, 18th century, 19th century also. They made lot many people have made attempt, and then they simply left as no solution, right? But like that, the Andrew Wiles is a student, Sir Andrew Wiles in 94, right? When he was born, in 1953, he was born in 1953, 11th April. In his school education, when he was 8 years boy, the history says, his teachers used to tell Fermat's last theorem has no solution. So at that time, Andrew Wiles has decided he wants to solve this problem. He would try. That's what his decision. So he was on that job immediately after his master's in mathematics. He was sitting on that same problem of Fermat's last theorem. Ultimately, he declared solution in 19 September. Actually, he declared solution in 1992 itself, I think so. I think 1992, he declared a solution, but there were some errors not accepted by IMU. International Mathematical Union has not accepted. So there are some errors they found. And again, he sit for 2 more years and then finally, ultimately, he solved it. So how does he solve this problem? Such a big problem, such a long years has no solution. So it is a commitment, it is a willingness, willfulness, and then at the same time, he concentrated on those mathematicians. They made attempts on this problem for the last 350 years. He collected all those literature where they miss, why they miss. But one thing, one plus point during his tenure in 1960s, after 1960s, the algebraic geometry has been come into the field after Galois and this work in algebraic geometry. Now at that time is growing, right? So that's why those techniques and everything he used, and then compiled the old mathematicians, they whatever they made attempts, and then he ultimately he declared the solution, he solved the problem. But he missed Fields Medal because he crossed 40 years. The Fields Medal he missed because he crossed 40 years by 1994. So Fields Medal will be awarded only to those great, those mathematicians who come up with a completely new work, those who are under 40 years by January 1st, every year, by January 1st. January 1st, the year of what is conducting the IMU, International Mathematical Union, International Mathematical Congress. So here, the Andrew Wiles has created black cats to solve this problem, Fermi last theorem, are deep theories like algebraic number theory and arithmetical algebraic geometry. So Rajwa. So he has make used to solve this problem, algebraic number theory and arithmetical algebraic geometry. So that's why he is a great mathematician, Andrew Wiles. So like this, Riemann hypothesis, Wiles conjectures, still open. Lot many problems are open. So the coming generations like you guys should come up with more concentrate on this, and then you should go on working on this, right? And then create black cats and solve the problems, the Hilbert problems. So 20th century mathematicians kept busy now with all these problems, Hilbert's problems, right? So there are a lot many things out there. We can discuss, we can discuss hours together on this. Many, many problems are still open. A lot of back cats are being created time and again due to such problems. So a lot of back cats are being created to solve such problems. So now for today's, this mathematician, in our talk, in our today, we are celebrating the birth anniversary. So now I think you can declare he is a great mathematician, Indian mathematician. He also lived for 30 years, 30 plus, lived for 30 plus. So Srinivasa Ramanujan, he also left behind many 4,000 theorems, left behind 4,000 theorems. So younger generations, they were busy with solving the problem, the theorems. So his friend G.H. Hardy, I think everybody knows this 1729 car number, 1729, the car number of G.H. Hardy. And when he said, G.H. Hardy said, when Ramanujan was on the deathbed in a hospital in UK, then G.H. Hardy came and he said, my car gave me a trouble and it's a dirty number, 1729. Then immediately Ramanujan said, it's not a dirty number. It is the least positive integer. Can be expressed as x cube plus y cube. So it can be expressed as like this. Ramanujan is such a great mathematician. And then at that time, no Fields medals during even Galois, even Ramanujan and many mathematicians, great mathematicians, no Fields medal at the world. The mathematicians have no Nobel Prize. I don't know how many of you are aware that the story. Why mathematicians are not having Nobel Prize? Nobel Prize is there for everyone except mathematicians, except for mathematics. And the Nobel has written in his will, after he acquired money, a lot of money from his research, a lot of money, when he was discovered, dynamite, he acquired a lot of money. And that kept in a bank, and then with that interest he declared, he has written in his will, mathematicians, Nobel Prize is there, Nobel Prize is for all science, for all subjects, except mathematics. That's what he has written in his will. So please go through that, why it's happened like that. I don't want to dwell on this occasion. So why mathematicians are not having Nobel Prize? That's why the Fields Medal. The Fields Medal will be distributed. Actually, it was instituted once in 4 years, International Mathematical Union. So there is a union, International Congress of Mathematicians, ICM. This ICM Congress will be held once in four years. After 102 years, in 2010, it was held in India. Hyderabad University has taken taken that responsibility, and in 2010, the ICM was held at Hyderabad. Right? So International Congress of Mathematicians is a group of mathematicians, International Congress. This was a Congress, and International Mathematical Union, under the auspices of the IMU, the ICM will be conducted, will be held. So during that time, during ICM, the Fields medals will be distributed. And other medals like, you know, Landmark, Gauss Prize, Abel's Prize. In 2010, the Chern medal is also instituted. These are all the greatest medals. Why I'm telling all these things to you? You are the younger generations. You choose mathematics as your career and do good research in mathematics and become a mathematician and acquire these prizes. Great prizes. These prizes are more than Nobel Prizes, right? The Fields Medal will be distributed once in 4 years. And initially, it was only for two medals in every 4 years. But after that, after 1936 or something, I think it was four medals will be distributed, will be for the four mathematicians who have done extraordinary research in mathematical, outstanding mathematical achievement, which will be awarded gold medals. It's almost equivalent cost with the Nobel Prize, right? The Fields Medals. So now, if Ramanujan would have been there, Ramanujan would have been got this awarded this Fields Medal, right? At the time, it was not there. It was instituted only in 1924. But after that, there was a gap. Some years gap is there because of the Second World War. And after that, again, it was instituted and it is continuing, right? But one surprising and one we can observe, one observation. No Indian got Fields Medal so far. No Indian mathematician received Fields Medal so far. See, but it doesn't mean, but I don't mean that our Indian mathematicians' research is not up to the outstanding. No. The condition for the Fields Medal is you have to come up with the outstanding mathematical achievement, research, right? Work, research work, below 40 years of age. But many of our mathematicians, in Indian mathematicians, they are very great mathematicians are there in TIFR and Ramanujan Institute, in Hyderabad University, ISI Calcutta. If you see, great mathematicians are there, right? But they have done, many mathematicians, they have done the outstanding mathematics only after 40 years of their age. So Fields Medal is having that restriction, but whereas Nobel Prize is not having that restriction, okay? So this is now the question to you, that wherein, so you try to achieve the Fields Medals. First of all, to become a good mathematician, you must love mathematics. That's what one great mathematician, he quoted. To become a good mathematician, how to become a good mathematician? Because today's our talk, my talk is completely on mathematician, who is a mathematician. So to become a good mathematician, you must love mathematics first, leaving everything, right? You must love mathematics. But I don't believe that leaving family. Leaving family means leaving everyone and then sitting in a dark room and do mathematics. It's not like that, right? Must love mathematics more than your family. More than your family. Right? Great mathematicians, they disgrace many number of times while solving their problems. They don't get solutions. but they will be discouraged, but they keep on doing mathematics. So when I'm doing my research, you know, sometimes many number of times discouraged, but at the same, again, we stop doing mathematics, and again, we start doing mathematics again from the morning onwards, like that. So that's why, unless you love mathematics more than your family, you cannot become a great mathematician, right? So I wish all the best. If you have any questions, maybe you can focus. I will try to answer.
Sir, thank you, sir. Mere already searching a black cat in dark room anaku questions ayundi sir. So mood questions adigaru ante meeku challenge endante inga mood unsolved problems unnai. Maybe someday this college students may solve these problems. Mere annatuga important sir. Karma and problem kuda ilaa solve chese avakasam undamo mana generation ante ee degree college students across the state. Maybe it's one challenge. Really wonderful session, sir. In spite of your busy schedule, ante administration undi kuda mathematics mele meeku enta hold undanukku. Really we appreciate from my bottom of the heart. You are an inspiration to this generation, so that they can also take up the mathematics as a one of the research area, particularly our government college students.
Actually, our students are all missing. They are not aware of the facts. See, because of this algebraic geometry, because of this Galois fields, right? Now they are entered into the chemistry, and then now the chemistry research is growing. Right. So that's why the students should know the history of mathematics, and then how it has come up, and then where are the applications are there. The applications. See, the general mathematician doesn't look into that application part, mathematician, but others, they look into that. This mathematics is useful to me or not, the sciences other than mathematics, science teachers, scientists, they work on that. Even through space technology, even everywhere, without mathematics, no technology at all. If the students, if you inject that into the blood of the students, then they choose mathematics. So that's what we are missing. Only they're coming, our teachers are just going to the classes, and then they're teaching abstract mathematics. That's all. They're not focused on application part. At least they don't mention. So that is why students should come up with the reading habit. They should read books. They don't read textbooks. So when I am student of degree, I used to refer 8 books in analysis. One paper I am studying 8 books. So these are all the like that. At those days, the teachers, they inspire. So we should focus on our teacher education also, wherein our teachers also should inspire the student. And then, because my teachers inspired me, that's why I chose in mathematics. Of course, I might not have achieved much in mathematics, but still, I'm very much satisfied. That's why the students, it's a should opt for mathematics and then keep on doing. Okay, Anil.
Yes, sir. Maybe you are observing this evening. We made it like a celebration. Ramalan's birthday, we made it like a celebration. And in this direction, we arranged it in a small campus lighting. We painted our colors. And we also able to invite very, very interesting and very important resource person, Professor Meena Gupta. Thank you very much, madam, for your patient presence and listening also. She is still there. I thank all my colleagues, all my faculty members, all my students for their round the clock work, sir. For arranging such type of work, we have strived for 1 week at least. And actually, we don't have any basic academic infrastructure. Still, we able to, with the support of our faculty and alumni, we could able to procure one LCD projector immediately and also scale. and we could able to live this program across the world. Maybe you are not able to see live, but there are many people who have connected in YouTube, Facebook, as well as LinkedIn across the world. Many of the faculty members as well as students are from abroad. That's what I am getting messages. Really wonderful evening, sir. Wonderful talk in spite of your busy administrative work, because it is showing your passion towards the subject. Just now you have transformed your imagination. You became a research scholar in the University of Hyderabad. You are appearing like that. With these few words, really thankful to you and also Professor Neena Gupta Madam. And I request my colleague Sulachana Madam to give a word of thanks. Thank you, sir. Please stay back there, sir.
Good evening, everybody. It's proud and privilege to propose vote of thanks on behalf of Ammar Government Degree College, Ammar Government Science College, and Government Degree College Vijayanagaram on the occasion of National Mathematics Day. At the outset, I would like to convey my gratitude to our beloved Principal Sir, Dr. P. Anil Kumar Sir, who has come forward to initiate such a wonderful and constructive program for the sake of the students. Now, I would like to convey my heartfelt gratitude to our Chief Guest, Professor Neena Gupta, who is hailed from ISR Kolkata, the first Indian recipient of Ramanujan Award. We should feel very blessed to have your presence, ma'am. And you have made a wonderful presentation on Srinivas Ramanujam and his works by referring William Blake's The Mystical Poem. And thank you so much again for accepting our invitation, madam. Now, I would like to extend my heartfelt gratitude to the Honorable Joint Director, sir, of APCCE Vijayawada for delivering an inspirational speech on solving mathematics problems at brief history. And I would like to extend my gratitude to Dr. Samuel sir for offering the technical support and to make our program very successful. And I would like to extend my gratitude to all the faculty, students, and other participants connected through this virtual platform to make this program very successful. Thank you so much to everybody.
Sir, finally, lot of thanks to our Honorable Commissioner Garu, Dr. Paula Bhaskar Garu, for supporting all these academic initiatives. In this connection, Honorable Commissioner Garu also promised to this college huge support in the coming days. Thank you very much, sir. I also thank academic cell members, AGO Garu, JD Garu, and all my friends from academic cell. I profusely thank Dr. Samuel Levitt from Dr. V.S. Krishna, who came all the way to give this live session. I once again thank all the faculty and particularly the students. Students of both the colleges are here. I give them a big clap. Thank you, sir. With those few words. Sir, as a tradition, we end the meeting with IK Mantram. Now I invite Ishwar and the team to recite this IK Mantram. Please.
संस्कृत ऐक्यता मंत्र
यम वैदिका मंत्र दृश पुराणा इंद्रम यमम मातरिश्वान माहु वेदांतिनो निर्वचनीयमेकम् यम ब्रह्म शब्देन विनिर्दिशन्ति सैवायमीशं शिवैत्यवोचन् यं वैष्णवा विष्णुरिति स्तुवन्ति బుద్ధస్తారన్నికి బౌద్ధ జైన శాస్త్రీయకాలేతి సిక్క సంత శాస్తేతి కేచిత్ ప్రకృతి కుమార స్వామీతి మాతేతి పితేతి భక్త్యా యం ప్రార్థయంతే జగదీశితారం స ఏక ఏవ ప్రభురద్వితీయః ఓం శాంతి శాంతి శాంతి
లోకా జన సుఖం భవంతు సర్వే సర్వమంగళాని భవంతు
Congratulations, Anil sir. Excellent. Well done, sir. Truly inspirational.
Hello, Anil sir.
Good evening. Good evening to all.
Boys, boys, stay back. Mana balla lapla yali. Boys, all boys.
హలో సార్, హలో, గుడ్ ఈవినింగ్, ఇన్స్పిరేషనల్ సార్ అనిల్ సార్, వెల్ డన్, కీప్ ఇట్ అప్, గ్రేట్ సార్, గ్రేట్ థింగ్. వీడియోనా ఎందుకు సార్? హలో సార్, గుడ్ ఈవినింగ్, కంగ్రాచులేషన్స్ సార్. Congratulations. The two lecturers are really scintillating, sir. The two lectures are extraordinary, thought-provoking and inspirational, sir. I'm really inspired. Thank you so much, sir. ఎక్కడున్న ఎక్కడున్నా సరే వీ కెన్ డూ మిరాకిల్స్ అన్న అని ఇంప్రూవ్డ్. థ్యాంక్ యూ సార్.
థ్యాంక్ యూ విత్ యువర్ సపోర్ట్. ఆల్
షల్ వి లీవ్ సార్? సార్ క్లోజ్ చేసి రిక్వెస్ట్. థ్యాంక్ యూ చెప్పలప్
సార్. సార్ థ్యాంక్ యూ ఆల్ వన్స్ అగైన్. We are closing this.